show.
So tight, so fly. You got me lifted. You got me lifted. You got me lifted, shifted higher than the ceiling. And ooh, it's the ultimate feeling. You got me lifted, feeling so gifted. Sugar, how you get so fly?
One of the famous shots that Phil is noted for is the flop shot. The technique is incredible. Phil, can you explain that?
Well, Roger, I need obviously a 60 degree wedge or more. I sometimes will use a 64, but the 60 degree is just as effective. I need to have bounce, actually.
More bounce will keep the club from digging too deeply into turf or sand. The amount of bounce needed depends on conditions. If you play courses with soft, fluffy surfaces, you'll need more bounce. If the courses you play typically have harder surfaces, you'll need less bounce. Playing from fairway, you need less bounce. Playing from rough, you need more bounce.
People think that I don't have bounce on this shot. I actually have 10 degrees of bounce, but I have this little concave groove we talked about with the leading edges sticking forward. It helps get underneath the ball.
Right.
The biggest thing in hitting the lob shot is assessing the lie. If we have one other ball, I'd like to point out there are two different lies here. One where the grass is fluffy and one where the grass is tight. I'm going to show you how to hit the one off of the tight lie here. And what I do is I want the club to go underneath the ball. The bounce kicks it into the ball, and that's how I get it to pop up. So I open up the face almost flat, so the toe is almost touching the ground.
Step one, open club face.
And I put my weight forward. This helps me drive the club into the ground and keep it underneath the ball.
Step two, keep your weight forward.
Now, if I were to let the club pass, what happens is the sole starts adding bounce, and the leading edge starts coming up off the ground, and I blade it.
Right.
So I have to make sure that my arm and club are accelerating together through impact. If I start stopping my arm and letting the wrist flip, that's when the leading edge comes up off the ground and blades it. So I've got my weight forward, the club is flat, the toe is almost hitting the ground, and I'm going to drive the club.
Step three, keep shaft and arm straight.
Right behind the ball. And I'm able to hit this soft little lob shot.
It's fucking Acrite. The question is, can I get some? It's fucking Acrite. The question is...
The bump and run is a safer alternative to the flop shot. The object is to get the ball on the green as soon as possible and to get the ball rolling like a putt.
No,
in.
Can't be.
Yep,
no, it can't be.
Holds it.
Just going to pop over the lip. Just going to duff it. Oh, I pulled it. No. Oh, spinner.
Ooh.
Whoa.
Put it back and have to hit a low shot. He cannot put it up in the air with the second cut that close behind the ball. You can see him putting it back in his stance right here and picking the club up like he's going to hit right down on it.
And he's picked out a landing spot that is a good 25 feet above the hole.
There's a good chance he doesn't get this inside DeMarco's ball.
Here it comes. Oh my goodness. Oh wow. In your life have you seen anything like that?